Hello, everybody. Welcome back to some more... Scrap Mechanic. Forgot the door opened up that way. I keep trying to hit R to run. I guess I was playing Firewatch too much, but we're going to head up here. And I'm going to delete this just because it's incredibly ugly and it's bugging me. You'll see down there, I said I was going to work on the DeLorean off camera, but I didn't have time to do that. And I don't really feel like working on it right now. Okay, we got to pick up all these scraps. I have another idea, just kind of a silly fun idea that I want to try out today. And so we'll do that. So DeLorean, we'll go ahead and put you off to the side, buddy. Is there any room for you in here? Inside our, in my garage? Yeah, there you go. You can chill out next to the RV. Don't necessarily have a door, but... yeah. I still need to fix this and make this wider. There we go, we got our fleet. It's supposed to be like a car, but it's like the size of our RV. I guess our RV is relatively small, especially compared to the player size, so... it all works out. It's all good, man. But what I want to try is I want to make...
what you got? What do you got? Oh.
Sorry. My dog found a little piece of plastic and he was... I looked at him when he's chewing on it and he just went... yeah, and he spit it out. Like, you little stinker. I want to make a, I want to see how tall of a car we can make. I was kind of inspired by one of the Scrap Mechanic trailers where they had the really ridiculously... It's a car that like got taller as you were driving it. And so, oh jeez, okay, I should probably close out Facebook, huh? Okay, that was just my girlfriend messaging me. Because we're going to go to Dairy Queen. And I was like, oh boy, I have time to record some Scrap Mechanic. Hopefully. If there actually is enough time. We're going to start with a relatively decent sized base. Actually, we'll probably cut it down from there. Okay, driver's seat. There you are. Okay, actually this is too big. It's one too wide. Go. Cut it down there, and that should be centered. Fantastic. Okay, and this is going to be a little tricky to think about. We're going to just try with one, and again, I'm building with wood. Just because. Okay, put that guy there. There. So we're basically just going to be doing a long row of this, and then we're going to try and make the car stand up. I don't know how well this is going to work, but I think maybe we should just stick with that. So now you can see we have all these joints there. And then basically the wheel would go right here. We'll do big wheels, just keep it stable. Right there. There we go. I don't think this is going to work very well. Let's actually move that right over there. So how many wide did we go? We get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. There you go. So again, I have no idea if this is going to work, but we're going to get something silly out of this. And the good thing about it is it's basically infinitely expandable. Because I can just keep adding them out. Yeah. This isn't going to work very well. Alright, well, let me get this other side. Alright, so we've got the tires hooked up to the engine. Engine. It's probably still going to be too high. And... so what happens if we try and drive this? Oh, they're not... oh, they're going the wrong way. Gosh darn it. Okay. You flip around. And you flip around. There we are. Now, it's like not getting traction because there's probably very little weight on it. Ah! Oh god. Oh man. This is not going to work very well, is it? Oh man. It's kind of like it's scooting forward. Oh god. Okay, when we pick it up, everything should straighten out and kind of untangle. Okay. Ah, oops. Let me do that. Okay, Mr. Controller, you're going to go right there. You're going to hook up, starting. So we're going to go like clockwise. That's what we're going to do every single time. There we are. So now when we take it off, at least those ones should stay relatively straight. This thing is ridiculous. It almost looks like a sled or something, because they're gonna keep running out forward. Oh, baby. Oh! And then it does not like when I get off of it. Okay. Oh, man. I actually have very high hopes for this. I kind of am tempted. Do I want a separate controller for all of them? Yes. Well, not all of them. At least the everything after the first one. Okay. So, here we go. There. There. Back. Back. That should be the second one. Yes, yes. Just want to make sure we have them all right. But now those ones should not extend wildly like this. Actually, when they're all hooked up, none of them should. To be honest. Okay, and then starting from this one, we'll go... So that comes over and goes there, so it's the closest one. There. There. And there, but you get the idea, so that's just how I'm gonna hook those up. Okay, I've got them all hooked up, and I completely forgot that on controllers, the maximum amount of bearings you can have hooked up is 10. So now, when we do that, it should all hold together. Sweet. Oh, a little fast. Okay, settle down, car. We don't need to go that powerful. There we go. Yeah, and steering will be easy to add eventually, so... Okay, hold on. Okay, sorry. Dog wanted to go outside. Or at least outside of my room. Okay. So the first ones. I guess I really could have, because this one only has 4. This one has 8. And this one has 8. Ah, that's okay. We can do it in stages. Okay, so this one we want these all to go... I guess it would be just... I guess it doesn't matter, because you can always switch the direction. So 90... It would probably be easier if we didn't make them straight up. It'd probably last a little, or at least do a little better. But hey, we'll just try it. Because we want it to be super tall, right? Like, if we made them taper out a little bit, it would give a little bit more of a little more balance. Okay, so let's sit in and... Somehow... How is this happening? Oh, there it goes. Ah! I fell over. Okay, yep, so we know, that one, so the front left and the back right need to be reversed. I clicked that twice for some reason. Oh, man. It's that one, right? There we go. So, yeah, it actually seems to be pretty stable. Okay. Okay, let's go ahead and put on a lift. Actually, no, we can do it from here, or we can at least... check from here. So then this guy, so that was that one. So then the second 1, 2, 3, and 4 want to go 180 degrees. Yes. So let's put it down. Ah, head stuck. So then now we have 1, 2, 3, and 4 want to go 180 degrees. 180 degrees. This is not gonna go well. Oh yeah, stupid lift. Oh, it's not hooked up to anything. Okay, yeah, well at least we can start from here. And that there. There. That there. And then 2. What? 2. Well, there's a bit of a miscalculation. Okay, I'm gonna have to think about that. Why is it doing that? It's because it's rotating around that axis, so these aren't rotating? Let me see, so we're coming out from there. We're going to, because we want these ones. So yeah, this one is rotating 180 degrees. And they are all disconnected like we saw from the chains earlier. So that's not the issue. The issue is, because it's just rotating around this axis. Okay, I think the problem is just because we just have that one going. So we actually need the second sequence to go next. That's 1, 2, 3, 4. And they come from this one. 5 should be right there. Okay, yeah. So if we just take this. And then if we make the next 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. So if these all go 180 as well. Okay, let's check that out. Ah, it's on a lift. Let's deactivate that button real quick. So 1, 2. Oh man. That was ridiculous looking, but technically it worked. Oh my god. I'm sorry, that is just really funny looking. So it works both ways. We can even do, what? And then, what? Even jump. Oh man. This is hilarious. What happens if we do it while we're driving? Would you like... Ah! Oh god, this thing works even better than the Bugger Mark II. So if we do like... Oh, wait, can we actually drive like this? Dude, this is like the dumbest transformer ever. Let's do it backwards. Ah! Let's see if we can get the flip back over. Oh, we're so close. Come on, you can do it, you can do it. It's making some weird noises. Alright, well, they can't quite flip over yet, but that first time was pretty freaking nuts. I just can't believe how well that works. Like, it's going so fast, like... And then... What? If I hit them both at the same time, it still works. Oh. Oh, yeah. Alright. Let's see if we can work on the next sequence. Oh. 1 second. Am I still... Okay, I wanted to make sure I was recording. I'm paranoid. I actually forgot that I wasn't recording a previous attempt at an episode, and I got kind of pissed off. Okay. So now, the next sequence of one will be this one. So they should just all work at 180 degrees once they're triggered. Because as long as they don't hit each other, which apparently they're not, we don't even have to reverse them. Actually, no, they're already going to be pointing vertically, so 180 degrees, no matter which direction, will be correct. You connect there, there. Okay, let's test this out. Good. Good, we should probably slow down the sequence, and... Stay! Oh my god! Wait, one of them's off. And then, 3, 2, 1. Okay, one of them is not at 180 degrees. 165, yes, I knew it. I can't believe this works. This is... 1, 2, 3. This is utterly ridiculous. What? 3, 2, 1. Why is that angle still with it? Oh, maybe I didn't fix it. Oh wait, there's another one here. Oh, maybe I just never fixed it. Okay, 180. Alt 180. This is hilarious. Okay. One, two, and three. Come on, stay. Oh my god, yes, it's tall. It's almost taller than C-Top Corp. It's definitely taller than my rocket, at least up there. Oh no! Ah! 3, 2, 1. Transform. Okay, let's test something. What happens if we slow them down all the way and then hit them all at the same time? Okay, and 1, 2, 3. That is so cool. It's kind of creepy, but it doesn't want to stay though, because I think from the little help it gets from the speed, it's actually pretty helpful. So we do like 1 and 2. And 3. Oh, it's so cool. That is so very cool. Okay, what is it? Alt F? No, Alt Z. Yeah, that's how you get rid of the UI. And in case you guys are wondering, that's how you get rid of the UI in this game. Man, I was playing Farmbots too long today. I keep trying to do R to run. Okay, Alt Z. There you go. Okay, what do you guys say we add one more layer? What'd you say to that, huh? We'll need a new controller. Actually, no, I want you to delete. Because right now these are hooked at the entrance, even though there is going to be a bearing there anyway. Better to just remove them all. Okay, good there. Good there. Good there. Okay. Out you go. In you go. In you go. Why did I say out you go? What? Is this one not in the right place? Okay, it is. Okay, next controller. I guess we'll just continue them in a row. The weight of the engine should displace this. If not, we can add some new ones. Okay, so this guy. You're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have now made this. What, 5 blocks taller? Should we go for broken, add a second one? Yeah, we're gonna go for we're just gonna add a second layer. Okay, we got that next layer hooked up. That's so cool. Okay, lower it down. We actually have to edit them, so all 180. 80, 180. Don't wanna do 165 again. Should be 8. Yes, there is. Okay. And is that key hooked up? Yes, it is. Okay. Lift. Get out of here. Let's change the speed, actually. I forgot I changed these all to slow. Whatever. Let's just go all out fast again. That seemed to work last time, but there is a different weight distribution now with the added layer and other things. Okay, that one's already on fast. So time to test. I forgot to have the engine hooked up. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Oh, come on, land it. Oh, yeah. Man, we actually get like the wind noise. This thing is so dumb, but so awesome. That'd be a great name for the great catchphrase for the channel. So dumb, but so awesome. Okay, let's put that back there. Take that off. I will hook these guys up to the engine. Probably will not be able to go very fast. There and there. And there. Okay, engine is already hooked up. Okay, oh, gotta reverse these wheels. Yes, it's always the left ones. So right now, it can drive. Should we just hit them all? 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh! Oh no. 4-3-2-1. And we're stuck in the ground. So that's a problem this game definitely has, is ground collisions. Okay, so we shouldn't do them all at the same time. So we can at least do 1-2-3, right? Ah, no, it doesn't work anymore. There's too much weight on the ends. Okay, so we gotta do them one at a time. That's okay. I didn't think the other way was gonna work anyway. So 1, 2, 3. And 4. Can we actually drive forward? We're technically driving. Look, we're scooting forward. Okay. Look how tall we are. We're taller than the base. Ah! Just keep on scooting. Well, that's, I think that's why my shadows look so bad. I don't think I ever fixed it. Yeah. I did that, when we were playing Scrapball, because it was help, the shadows were getting a little messed up, but... And then what happens when we try and close it? 4-3-2-1. Oh, and it technically all came back together. Let's do it while we're driving, ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh wait, I hit 3 twice. Oh, my legs got tangled. Oh, is it gonna fix itself? No! Bam. Okay, just for one last test, let's see what happens if we do them out of order. So if we do 4, 3, 2. Oh, I got stuck in the ground. Okay. Let's do 2. Okay, let it calm down. 3, 4. And. Well, I guess that's a way to do it, too. Let's gun it, Grandma. Ah! And he got stuck in the ground again. Whoa, whoa! Hey, I made it out. Alright. Well, if you guys have any ideas for what to name this monstrosity, definitely leave them in the comments below. Also, leave a like if you did enjoy. This was kind of just a screwing around episode. They're pretty fun to do from time to time. I'll see you guys next time for some more Scrap Mechanic. Bye.